Alert. Our control point is being captured.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Kip TV. I am Kip, and I have the second iteration of Ready, Steady, Pan for you today. I first brought you the first map, or first game of the first match, which it's all about the Gibbous 1, 3-0. So they are up in this tournament, but it is the best of three games that makes up one match. So that means we have at least one more game to play on this special day, this special cast of It's or of Ready Steady Pan. So of course we're watching It's All About the Gibbous. We're watching Jonah FC right now go for Spire. He fell down now, but coming up and going for the pan kill. Actually decides not to because most of Red is there. Who is Red Team, you ask? Red Team is, you just got panned. And indeed, they are doing some panning right now. Oh, both Special K and Jonah FC go down on the point. Johnny Murloc Johnny is up there, but he goes down too, so it looks like Red will be able to defend Spire right now. My HUD is not working correctly, but that's okay. We are on Badlands, and it is, of course, capture point. There we go. That's the word, I think. Anyway, S-Nut is back here on Red Spire. He sees the soldier coming from him. It's going to be a Pandal. He knows it, but does he know that there's... Oh, and S-Nut actually falls, so Sprayer takes him down. Mew is climbing his way slowly up, and uh-oh, man, I hope you have your volume on really loud so you can hear all this glorious pan noise. Let's just have a listen. So good. So good. Oh, I'm sorry. But Fragger just got a nice kill on Murloc Johnny, so he's going to be able to proceed to mid, and hopefully he thinks that he will be able to cap it for You Just Got Panned. Unfortunately, here comes S-Nut with a nice jump in and nice damage done to him. Apache Flame is hiding in the fan. We actually saw... I think he actually did this first round too. So Freaky going for an air shot there with his rocket jumper, which is probably not gonna happen, or not gonna do a lot of damage at least. Jonah FC going down on Spire, but actually the rest of his team is here to pick him up. Sniper's on the point. Can Gibbous take him down? No, S-Nut goes down. The question is, can Special K do it? Special K is joined by Mew, I believe. No, he's joined by, I'm sorry, Murloc Johnny's the only soldier for It's All About the Gibbous. And they'll be here to... There we go, take him out. Actually, no, Special K has Gun Soldier. Apache Flame is the only scout for It's All About the Gibbous. Pretty much covers, I think, we've seen all of Gibbous's team. So for You Just Got Panned, we have Sprayer as Soldier, Fragger as Demo. Safinisk is sniping, Fast Forward is Demo, Freaky is Soldier, and Emperor Pear is Scout. We are watching Emperor Pear's cam right now, and of course he's rocking the Mad Milk, which is allowed. And you're wondering, where are the medics, where are the heavies? Well, those are not allowed. This is not Highlander, this is not even Sixes. And wow, little spy cap there from the scouts, I believe. So Gibbous is able to go up 1-0. In this round, we'll watch Jonah C's rollout because he is an excellent demo for Highlander and Sixes. It looks like he kind of screwed that up a little bit, but he's going to do a big old jump and try to get in there. So getting some actually pretty good distance. Oh man, he wants to go for Spire again. Looks like he's really trying to be aggressive. I don't think Gibbous has mid yet, but looks like You Just Got Panned is just setting up on second. Their red Spire. They are not going to let this go. But look at these jumping soldiers coming. Jumping soldiers and jumping demos just coming in. S-Nut just hanging out on the top, and the other soldiers get up there with him. And again, we just hear the glory of the pan. The sound is just ridiculous. And then the screams, I think, are the worst. Maybe I should put on pyro vision so it's laughing instead of this brutal noise, and S-Nut getting the nice taunt in there. Jonah FC is stalking this last point right now. He is not able to cap it at this moment, dropping down, going for the cap. He was right beyond the demo, not able to get the kill because, of course, you have to get a couple hits with the pan, and actually goes down. So Joe's little plan right there did not work. So we are. So Red successfully defends their point. Looks like Mew is already ready to give them this round. Not sure what that means. But Mew, being the scout that he is, and is rocking his gibbous. I think everybody on gibbous is wearing their gibbous. They better be, at least.
The control point is being captured.
Again, I'm not sure what's wrong with my HUD, but be it this is just kind of like a fooling around tournament, I'm not too worried about it. We will try to get as much action as we can, but it's really those top of the spires battles of the pan. Let's see what's going on here. It looks like Special K, who's not wearing his gibbous, wants to get in there. Murloc Johnny goes down, was covered in pee, and there goes Special K again. I think we had an issue of somebody using a weapon that was banned, and now our teams are discussing what is going to happen in this situation. So we will stay tuned. I believe Chippy looks like is the admin. And just going over the rules real quick, it looks like we do have this question about the rules. Just so you know, there's no medics, no heavies, no spies, and no engineers. Looks like we are going to start over, and I think it's still 1-0 Gibbous, and they were just given this extra, they're given mid and able to start over again, because I believe somebody on a red used a banned weapon. Of course, what's banned? Well, basically everything that does damage, except the fan. So the things that are allowed in addition to the fan, first of all, we gotta watch this fight. Gibbous looking really good right now, up 2 players. Atomic Punch comes out, and that does really, really help Special K with his panliness. Even though Esnaut and Mew are... Oh, I'm sorry, Mew brought out the... Oh, wow, and who is on last? Jonah C doing a sneaky cap on last. So they really like those. I bet he was hiding in the fans again. Because, yeah, Gibbous likes those sneaky stuff. So anyway, just real quick, the other weapons that are allowed are the Sticky Jumper, obviously, watching that action now, the Rocket Jumper, Bonk, Atomic Punch, Jurati, Mad Milk, and the Criticola. Also are the booties for the demo and his peg leg. Jonah C just really going for it right now, waiting for his team to get Spire, and then he's just gonna be a spy cap right here. Be a spy cap. Go for the spy cap, so we're gonna wait and watch him. Gibbous just now capping mid, so he's gonna have to wait a little bit longer. Especially, Murloc Johnny falls to a clumsy, painful death. Of course, that's another way to die. If you don't die from the pan, you can die from gravity. Which, sadly, Murloc Johnny has just figured out. Looks like, though, Red is able to cap mid, so wherever Jonah C is, he has got to fall back and try to help out his team right here. Because they are going for Blue Spire and looking pretty good about it, because Gibbous was actually three down just a second ago. They're getting the respawns now. But Fragger and his soldier are on the point, looking very paranoid, going for the crouch. Here comes Mew. Mew goes down to force the pan. But here comes Johnny Murloc. Murloc Johnny. I'm just going to call him Johnny, because anyway, they're going for Spire. It looks like they are reverting it. Finally, they are able to cap their own Spire. But who is this soldier who's just jumping back in there? That's freaky. He says, okay, well, you guys are done with this point. Well, can I have it now? Thanks. And he's going to have to battle Johnny to get it. Johnny is outnumbered, and he goes down. Looks like Spire is going to go to Red. You just got panned is pushing in very heavy right now. Two last. This could be their one opportunity. The closest they've been to actually capping and finishing or winning a round. And looks like Freaky takes down Special K. And that is... Oh no! Here comes Mew. Barely in time to take down Freaky. But he's abandoning the point right now. May not be the best idea. There's red players still around. And Mew's... One of Mew's binds is, I just stole your lucky charms. And it's even better if you know that Mew is very Irish. Although I can't imagine how you'd be a little bit Irish, but you know, we Americans tend to all identify as a little bit of Irish, at least on St. Patrick's Day. Anyway, here comes Johnny up with a nice sticky jump or rocket jump, able to defend the spire, and now rolling back to blue or to mid, which is capped currently by blue. So they need to get red spire is and that's their next plan. Murloc Johnny getting there, has to deal with, takes a pay into the face and goes down. Here comes Special K with the jump in, trying to get some pan action, doing a lot of damage. Does take down Fragger, but he's got to take down Freaky, and he does. Can he take down this Scout, though, is the question. He gets some reinforcements. Scout goes down, but Special K goes down. Apache Flame goes down. Here are the two demos on one soldier, though. This is not looking too bad. Oh! Finally, though, Esnaut is the king of the mountain. He is the one who can survive the longest with a pan in his hand. So, Esnaut is the man with the pan in his hand. Yeah. I'm pleased about that. We'll see if he can go into last, though. He's probably going to have to wait for reinforcements here because he's going to have to take the entire team. And actually, fast forward, I believe, is going for Spire again. Fast forward does go down to the entire Gibbous team. So Gibbous is now pushing into last. Esfignus goes down too, so this is going to be a very good opportunity for Blue to push. And they are pushing, except there's everybody is on red that's alive with those pans drawn out. Apache Flame goes down, so that's a not a times two that we'll have on the point. Jonup C getting a nice kill on Freaky. Back behind the point though right now. They need to get on the point. Both demos are on Joe right now. We'll see if he can do it. No, he does go down. But look at that. A sneaky cap by Special K gets in there while the demos were distracted behind the point. So it is 2-0, I believe, I guess. This crap, says Sprayer. Oh no, it's great fun. This is funny. Well, I mean fun and funny at the same time. Just look at those scores. They're really quite humorous because it's so hard to kill. Or there's just a lot less frags going on, I guess. Would you say that? I think, because you're not going to get a whole lot of 2K, 3K streaks. You're just going to get a K and then die and then come back up and then die. And then so, you can melt into the point like that demo did. But anyway, Gibbous taking mid very convincingly, only losing one player, and that's Joe. Esnaut and Mew are really, really hurt right now, but they're going to fall back or push forward, actually, to Spire, looking very strong right now. Murloc Johnny is already on the point, helping them out. This would be the point where they'd be spamming and putting down some stickies and fun stuff like that, but of course it's not happening, which is still takes some getting used to. That these things that you're so normal to are not happening. Esnaut going for the falcon perch, because he's perching up on top of the point and doesn't look like you just got panned. No, he's there, which they really should, because he and Joe Nefsy have done this several times before. But Esnaut does go down. Fast forward was able to take him. So you just got panned, having a nice player advantage right now. If they want to push back, they do push back onto the mid, to Spire, and retake their Spire. Now they're looking for mid. Gonna have to deal with Mew right here, who's pesky, but he does go down. So again, they have this player advantage as they push back onto mid. Johnny is engaged with Sprayer. Sprayer goes down. Now Johnny gets to deal with the other soldier, Freaky, but Freaky goes down too. That time Johnny had some help from Apache Flame, though. Let's see who wins in this battle between Demo with Cloud over his head and Pink Hatted Soldier, and it is Pink Hatted Soldier! So Murloc Johnny able to get that win, and now pushing onto Spire. However, Esnaut is already there already, and oh, missed that jump. Sorry, I caught that on camera, Esnaut, but you should know better. So trying to get in here, doing the same thing again, and I wonder if Red is going to have any idea how to deal with this time. It's not like they can send spam up there, but demos can jump up and then pull out the pan, I guess. It would be very tricky. It looks like that's what the soldier is trying to do right now. Unfortunately, Esnaut would be waiting up there with his pan, but actually Esnaut went down. Murloc Johnny is sneaking around the point. I don't think anyone knows he's there. He's going to try to go for a kill on this sniper. He is so hurt, and it did not take much for a Sphinx to take him down. Meanwhile, two scouts and Demo are defending Red Spire right here. looks like it will stay in Blue's control, and the action is going to go back again to the last point. But look here, Freaky, now he's starting to... Now, what am I trying to say? Now, you just got pinned is responding to the tactics that Gibbous has been using. Looks like Freaky wanted to get up there and, you know, take away that open space from S-Knot. They were able to defend right there and take down S-Knot, so at least they are definitely aware of those tactics right now and trying to limit Gibbous's employment or use of them. Fragger doing some nice action on the top. He's pretty hurt, but can he take down Jonufsy? Jonufsy has got so much more health, and he stays alive, so Blue will take or keep control of Red Spire right now. Two scouts pushing in. That's Apache Flame and Mew. Both of them stay alive, and oh, there goes Apache Flame. But oh, here comes S-Knot. He's looking really aggressive, kind of wants to do this whole thing on his own, but if he doesn't have stickies that explode and do damage, it's going to be really hard. Oh, the entire red team just falling in on Joe and Johnny and just absolutely annihilating them with their pants. Special K is left wanting to do some damage, but just kind of jumping around because he's not too sure how to go about doing that. Oh, he's a distraction play. Well, S-Knot comes in. S-Knot gets the kill on Emperor Pear, but he's got to get three others and not able to do it. So, unfortunate there. Special K is still jumping around. I don't know actually if he was a distraction play, if that was on purpose, but it worked to Gibbous's almost advantage. If they had gotten one more player on the point, they probably could have taken it right there. Special K goes down, though. Here comes Joe with the pan, obviously. With Johnny doing a ton of damage, but both Johnny and Joe go down again. So, unfortunate right there. For Gibbous, just not able to get that last person in there or that last one survivor to finish off the cap. So it looks like You Just Got Panned has quite a good chance right now of coming back if they are able to cap Spire, which is what they are doing as we speak. And Spire goes to them.
The control point is being contested.
Oh, Special K, covered in milk, knocks off the soldier, but actually soldier survives. Fast forward does not, and he is lying on the ground dead while his soldier jumps around trying to stay alive. It's interesting, You Just Got Pan's use of the sniper. Of course you do get the Durati with that, which with mini crits is so nice. But then you don't get the jumping advantage of you would with a, Mew goes down. You Just Got Pan does have two demos, two soldiers, so they do have that type of jumping advantage, but they don't have the speed advantage that Gibbous does with two scouts. So, again, You Just Got Pan is running the sniper instead of a scout to get that Jurati. And, I don't know, it's just an interesting strategy. It's just a different type of thinking, too. You have to think about strategy where, oh god, S-Knot was just completely owned right there, covered in, red player is not able to get it. Here comes Special K. Let's see if he can get it. He's covered in P, and that's where the sniper Jurati really comes in handy when there's just a ton of people on the point. You can cover them all very easily. Right now you see Red, it's just a second ago, was covered in the Mad Milk, and because they were all so close together, that was evenly spread over them and a good use of your secondary weapon slot. Especially if you're not able to use that shotgun, you might as well use something. And let's see if Sifinkus is able to finish off that demo. He's not able to, and S-Knot gets in and gets out.
The control point is being captured.
So it's looks like You Just Got Pan's strategy is just now to stand on the point and just to occupy space, which is usually a terrible strategy because if you're all on this point, then you can easily be spammed by the other team. But of course, you can't spam the pan. I mean, I guess in real life you could throw it or something like that, which would be really funny and also dangerous, but you know, it is war. Unfortunately though, with just the pan, you can't spam in stickies or pills or rockets or anything like that, so the other team can just stand there, and that's a legitimate type of defense. So, Gibbous is going to have to rethink their tactics if they are going to want to, want to push in and take this. Mew, again, we're seeing is hiding in the fans. Let's just hope nobody turns them on Mew. Looks like this is going to be their tactic of just playing sneaky and waiting.
The control point is being captured.
or at least distraction, as a catchy flame comes in there, tries to lure people off, I guess, but then also get some damage done as well. Not able to do so, and... ooh, that's not getting in there. Oh, here's a distraction ploy as Mew crept onto the point, but unfortunately not enough time, and looks like Esnaut is going to go down. No, actually, he's still alive. Now he's going to go down, covered in Jurati. Mad Milk all over the place as well. Apache Flame doing some damage, but he gets covered in milk too, so he goes down. Gibbous just can't put this final push together, and I can't imagine it's easy, but at the same time, it's just a pan. But I don't know, at least. Redcap Spire again, so they're making their push back out, which is took them a while after several failed attempts by Gibbous. They're finally now being aggressive. Frogger goes down, though. He was the only one on top of the Spire. Here comes a soldier finally to help him out. Jurati goes down on the point. And so Special K and Apache Flame do go down. So you see the use of the Jurati there. Very, very nice.
Point is being contested.
Looks like we're going on to pushing on to mid with you just got panned. Mew is able to take down Emperor Pear. Freaky takes down Mew, though. Who's going to take down Freaky is the question next. That's the way it goes. Ton of craziness on the point because it's the pan. Of course it's going to be crazy. Freaky does go down. But Frogger able to get back in there and take down Murloc Johnny. Special K and the demo going at it now, but here comes Jonah C to ruin the fun. And looks like that'll be a good defense right there of mid from the Gibbous team. Emperor Pear, though, however, is behind the lines, kind of. He is pushing forward, even though they do not have mid. Looks like he's coming back for it now. Gets some milk on Joe, and with one hit, Joe goes down. So a nice hit right there. However, Emperor Pear is going to have a lot of maneuvering to do if he wants to get away. But Murloc and Special K does not. Not able to. So Esnaut going. Oh, this fancy jump right there. Going for Spire again. Got a ton of people to deal with. Actually grabs a health kit. So he's able to stay alive and go in for some more. He's really using that sticky jumper to the best of its usage. So love to see that because nobody uses that in competitive competition is what I'm trying to win. Mew coming out, trying to get the sniper, does get him with the pan, obviously. Esfinitz goes down, so don't have to worry about Jurati for the moment. Gibbous is going to be able to cap this in half a second. Oh no, here comes the demo. Frogger able to defend at the last moment. Joe did not see him, jumped off, and now returns. Not able to get the kill, though. Joe goes down. Mew and Special K are on the point. Here comes Esnaut to help, and finally Frogger does go down. So Frogger fast forward, and now Emperor Pear are down too. We're gonna watch Mew because he's gonna try to get in here as soon as possible. He's really, really hurt right now. Too bad there's no medics. Getting some hits on the soldier. Looks like is he gonna jump back into the fan? He is. So we will watch somebody else. It's an interesting strategy right there. It worked. It has almost worked, so I'm not surprised that they're trying to run it again. I'm just a little skeptical that it's the best way. Here comes Johnny on the point with the pan and doing a ton of damage right there, taking down Freaky, but he goes down. Mew is left. Mew is the only one left. And there we go. Mew gets the cap. So it is now 3-0. And are we starting over? I'm not sure. I didn't get instructions about how this game is going. Looks like we are starting over, so that is the second round. The second game of the match. So Gibbous is now up 2-0, I think. I'm not even sure. You know what? We'll just keep casting until the demo ends, and then we'll deal with it then. So here we go. Gibbous, again, it looks like they're taking mid fairly easily. I wonder if You just got Panda's gonna go for their same strategy of just defending, and it looks like they are. Everybody is on top of Spire, which means we're gonna have a classic Spire-Pan mashup. We'll stay here, turn up your earphones. Oh, actually, Joe can't get there. Here comes Johnny trying to get it in. And hear the clang, somebody's making dinner.
The control point is being contested.
Or breakfast, I guess. You really use wrought iron cast pans for breakfast, not for dinner. And that's what these are, let's be honest. I think the engineer should definitely have one, because those are the type of pans you definitely use over the open fire when you're camping and stuff, and that's just NG right there, so. Anyway, that's just my NG beef with the pan. S-Not, waiting for everybody to get off the point and then coming back and trying to cap it by himself, actually gonna go down, because it's hard when there are three people hitting you with a pan and you have just one pan to defend yourself. Meanwhile, though, Gibbous was able to push back onto their spire and recap their spire. Mew has his eyes on this demo and gets it down. Gets the Jurati down? Scout can't use Jurati, can he? Wait, Mew's sniping! That explains that. Also explains the pinky up, because it's the sniper who does that when holding onto the pan. So Mew has gone sniper, which is an interesting change of strategy. Looks like they do want to utilize that Jurati. Or that Jarate. So that's them now adapting to You Just Got Pan's tactics. Joe going down, Fragger is looking really solid. He's got a really good match. So far, scores have been reset, but as you can see, pretty much even. These teams are very evenly matched, even though this game, or this type of setup at least, is very wonky. Again, I'm not sure if You Just Got Panned is a Highlander team, or Sixes team, or anything like that, but Gibbous, of course, does have both of those, so they are very experienced working with each other and practicing and all that fun stuff. Just probably not that experienced with the pan. Fragger taking an Apache Flame with a nice kill. Fragger also getting Joan of C. So, we also have some changes around. Joe has gone Scouts. Mew, as we said, is sniping. I think that's it, actually. Alright, so, not so much. Looks like everything is the same on You Just Got Panned. Sprayer trying to get Jonah C, who had nice little loop around air strafing through the spire. Here he comes again, another more just nice little air strafing, but not able to help him out as he goes down on spire. Here comes You Just Got Panned with a vengeance. They are pushing into last, very strong, very hard. Murloc, Johnny, and Mew are here though, ready and waiting. They don't have to worry about those sticky bombs, because they're not going to do anything, but the P will definitely help out, and Johnny goes down, but somehow S-Not is able to get in there and defend, but no, he definitely is not able to defend against that, and why isn't he capping? Probably because Spire is not capped yet. Indeed, Spire is still in Blue's control. Red is going to have it very quickly, though, and we'll see what's happening at last right now. Mew and Johnny are back on there, actually, able to respawn in time and defend. So You Just Got Panned is going to have a difficult time pushing in here. They are covered in P, but there are about 3-4 more of them, and oh, wow. It's all about the Gibbous is able to defend. I wasn't even sure how to cast that or to describe the action, because sometimes there are just no words, you know? Joe Nupsy working on capping Spire back. Does get it, is on the prowl, stalking the sniper. Sniper has figured him out though, so Joe is going to have to get some health and figure out how to take this guy down. Looks like Sfnisk actually already did go down, so Joe's going to have to pick a new target. His new target, anybody in red. And just whack in the pan wherever. It's very different from Highlander or Six's play, you will see competitively, because when players are aiming and shooting, they're always targeting somebody. There's one person that they want to kill. With the pan, it just seems like you hit anyone who's near, and whoever goes down just goes down. So sometimes it looks like the teams are coordinating and saying, okay, right now we're targeting the demo. Everybody surround the demo and hit him with a pan, okay? But a lot of the other times, it just looks like you hit anyone who is within hitting distance, you know? So I can imagine that's really frustrating if you are a competitive player, being like, I just hit whoever and hopefully someone will die, instead of having this very conscious effort of the demo man is my target and will be until I take him down. But such is the nature of ridiculous tournaments such as this. Gibbous is looking to push on to Spire. Freaky is here and waiting, though. Actually, that Special K just did a huge jump over. Oh, interesting. S-Knot is on Pyro. It was the demo who was first able to wield the pan. And so, that's how this all started. Pyro, though, of course, now able to wield it. I wonder what loadout he has that makes him think it will be useful for... that Pyro will be useful for such a setting. We will get on the spot cam.
Alert.
Oh,
the control point is being contested.
He's back to demo. Sad. Must have realized there's probably not a whole lot of use in going pyro for this type of competition. Although I wonder if the air blast
is being used.
Because on Spire or something, that could really be useful. I'm not sure though. Nothing I can see just from a quick glance at the rules. If you're interested in learning more, definitely go to, I think it's just ReadySteadyPan.com, or ReadySteadyPan is a subreddit on Reddit, so just search for that, or reddit.com/r/ReadySteadyPan. If you're not on Reddit, you should be. And that is my Reddit announcement of the day. Mew getting in here, getting the P down on all three people from ReadySteadyPan who are on the point, but he is... has already taken a lot of damage, so Mew's going to have to fall back, not able to pursue that point right there. It looks like the first few rounds were really going Gibbous's way, but it looks like Ready Steady Pan is, I mean, You Just Got Panned has really picked up their game, found ways to adapt, and found strategies like two demos just barreling in on the point right there. That is terrifying, and although they are covered in pee, who's gonna win? Mew goes down, and Apache Flame goes down. So Frigger doing a great job right there, wanting to push back in at this moment for last. Can they do it though? He is... oh, not for last, for mid, that's right. I'm sorry, I really wish my HUD was working right now, but it's not. Anyway, so Frigger going for mid. Still trying to figure out who is going to win or how people do win in this situation. It is, Jonah C. I mean, S-Knot took Frigger's. Frigger's health, but Frigger was not able to follow up and get that kill because he was so low on health. Jonah C, meanwhile, doing some nice work and actually dominating Freaky, which I can imagine is. There's probably a lot of dominations going on right here because it's the pan, and look at that, just Gibbous completely swarming the point and taking down Sprayer. No chance. And it looks like Gibbous goes up 1-0 and we're going to another round, so I don't know when we're going to or how long. It looks like we have 10 minutes left, so we'll say there's at least 10 minutes left to play, or we're saying there's just 10 minutes left. I don't know. So we've seen Gibbous kind of mix up their roster, try sniping. Mew is actually still back on the sniper, using that Jarate. Actually getting some nice down there. And listen to the pans. Maybe I should tape that and make it my ringtone. I'm sure that won't get annoying.
Our control point is being captured.
Actually had the demo's kaboom as my ringtone for a while, and it got very annoying. Anyway, Gibbous doing some nice work on the points and managing to take Spire, Red Spire. It looks like, yes, indeed, there's only three up, only four right now. Four, you just got panned. Gibbous needs to push right now if they want to continue this momentum, which they do, because last round went way too long, in their opinion, I would think, at least. But Red is getting the respawns, getting those player advantages back up, and it doesn't look like Gibbous will be able to take advantage. And also, there's a bat cap going on. Fragger trying to go for Spire, but both soldiers, Special K and Murloc Johnny, there to take him down. So now the teams are tied in player numbers. But, oh, and now Apache Flame is down. Covered in Milk are the You Just Got Pan team. But they still have the numbers? No, no, they don't. Special K and Johnny are just going crazy. I think Special K is on like a 3K streak with the Pan, so we will stick with him and see what he decides to do. Actually, jumping away, getting away, runs into a demo on the upstairs, and oh! Fragger takes him down. That's not seeing if he can't avenge his friend, and does so by running away, not able to do it, and goes down. So you just got panned again, has this a nice little advantage. Gonna have to take down Johnny though if he wants to take Spire, and indeed Freaky does take down Johnny, so it looks like yeah, you just got panned is, especially Fragger, are doing some nice work right there in terms of points. It's really increased in the last few minutes. Freaky does go down, but that's what's happened when you have four people hitting with your pan instead of just one. Got some nice defense, and by defense I mean standing there. But that's all you can do right at this point with the pan as the primary weapon. Esnaut trying to get in there, just trying to feel things out, maybe trying to distract people. Is there anybody in the vents? There is somebody in the vents. Who is that? That is Jonah C. He's waiting for you just got planned to either abandon the point or to die. Right now they're covered in pee, so it could be close. Fast forward is down. But Fragger able to come in there. Apache Flame trying to get in there and take the soldier down, not able to, and Spurrier does take him down. So, crazy craziness. At least we can see a pat. Oh, whoa! What happened there? Special K comes in from behind and gets the cap. So he waited to until there's just one person up, and I think that person was just respawning. I think that was Fragger, I'm not actually sure. So anyway, that was a crazy little sneaky ninja cap right there. So we are seeing how Gibbous likes to do their caps, which is usually pretty sneaky, and include hiding in vents and hiding on the top of the point. Not a lot of action here at mid right now. Okay, now people are joining. Usually the previous rounds we've seen at mid are just completely piled with people, and Gibbous coming in very strong, putting half of the You Just Got Pan team away. Here comes Fragger, I believe, actually just doing some crazy jumping, completely overshooting the point. I think that is what he wanted to do. But now it's just falling back to get health, I guess. Here we go, Gibbous, though, looking very strong. Probably all at Spire right now. And yes, Fragger is coming in, trying to get some Ks right here. Actually getting a good amount, and half of the Gibbous team going down. Fragger with Johnny is... No, Johnny cannot withstand the hands of three people, so he goes down. Fragger, we're just going to stay on his cam right now, because he is, you know, top scoring in this server, so we will see what he has decided or discovered about the pan that some people else on his team are missing, because it looks like Freaky is, you know, only got 9 in this round. So, not or this game. I'm not sure what I'm calling it. But anyway, the pan can be so tricky to use, and I just wonder how much experience and how much practice these guys put into it. I know that I actually... Oh! You just got panned, coming back, able to take the win. Who was that with the cap? I didn't even see, but some nice ninja right there. It looks like the only way to do this is to ninja cap, or be surprised. Or at least I'm always surprised because my stupid HUD isn't working, but you just got panned. Emperor Paris finally able to use that bind. I hope it's in the bind because he capitalized the O. But anyway, there he goes. He's excited. So it does go 2-1, but remember, Gibbous is up 2 games, and we're going, I think, the first till 3. So Looks like they're leaving the sniper back to depend, so Efnisk is defending Spire all by his lonesome self. Meanwhile, epic pan battle going on, and Joe goes down to Emperor Pear, or to Fragger. Emperor Pear is there with him to help cap the point. Looks like Joe is going Pyro, which is interesting. We saw, he was, and now he is. No, Joe is still on Pyro.
Time has been added.
And, interesting, you just got panned, almost had a complete wipe of the Gibbous team. So, first time that's happened, I believe. So, you just got panned is feeling very confident right now. But Gibbous is going to go for their sneaky tactics again and just keep their demo men up here in the top, on the top of the point, so when people do come from you just got panned, they're able to fall down and take them down with the a black pan to the forehead. Looks like, though, those demos will be able to push back up because Gibbous is probably going to take mid right here. Murloc Johnny going down, but Special K and the scouts are there to help pick up the slack. And can they get this one scout? Yes! Emperor Pear is down, and Sphinx is down too, but oh, Fast Forward comes out of nowhere with a lot of health and finishes off Special K. Oh no, here comes Joe. Joe is back on demo and takes down.
Cheers, man.
And now he's going to drink his pan. There we go. Remember, boys and girls, start off your day with a healthy dose of pan. And goes down. Fragger goes down to Joe. So Joe on a nice little streak right now. We'll see if we can get on his cam. Indeed, he is going for Spire. Looks like he may have missed a jump right there. Not sure. Or maybe he's just waiting for the sniper. Either way, interesting little maneuver right there. The important thing, I would guess, about playing this type of format is you have to know where the med packs are because you can't have a medic in this. Oh gosh, nice nice pan right there. Oh, but Joe goes down. Red Spire is going to stay red, and Joe actually, did Joe go down? I'm confused. No, Joe's still right there. What happened? I would say it would be a spy, but there are no spies. I guess that's easy, or it makes it a little bit easier knowing that the spy is not allowed. You don't have to spy check at all, so that's gotta be nice. Gibbous still maintaining mid right now, so looking okay. There's 2 minutes left. I'm guessing we're playing till a time limit. My guess, at least. Looks like Freaky has really picked up momentum in the past few minutes, getting about 10 points just, since I mentioned that he may be having some trouble. So we'll try to get to his camp. Mew taking down Sprayer. I think I'm just calling him Sprayer. Oh, did you see that? Fragger comes out of nowhere and just annihilates Mew with the pan. Here comes Joe and Murloc Johnny and Apache Flame. Can Fragger take them all down? He's just gonna sit up on top of this light. Oh, Murloc Johnny comes in, tries to get him, gets a big pan to the face. What an epic battle. Just completely epic. No one wins that, but you know, when you're fighting with pans, maybe we're all really losers. Anyway, here comes a more mid-fight battle. Looks like Mew may have been AFK or something. He's using Bonk. Yes, he is using Bonk. Bonk is allowed. It's all about the Gibbous. Only S not alive jumps in there just to take a few hits and then decides to GTFO. He is still jumping around with only 2 health. Actually dies in that last sticky jump. He was not able to survive the fall. So gravity, thy cruel bitch. And that is the end of S-Nod. Looks, you just got Pan looking very strong right now. Need to capture the Spire. Need to get Apache Flame out of there. And he does go down, so you just got Pan managed to cap it. Here comes Special K, 2-on-1 though, and Special K does go down. Not a whole lot of, not a whole lot he could have done right there. But on the point, we have Mew, who has gone back to scout. He has gone back a few minutes ago, actually. But here comes the entire red team. You just got pandas piling on the point. Everybody's on the point right there. What time limit is reached? I think almost literally almost everybody was on the point right there. So that was absolutely ridiculous. They're calling GG. I am not sure. It looks like somebody is disconnecting, so we will call that the end of the game. So, ladies and gentlemen, thank you for joining me for the rest of this match between It's All About the Gibbous and You Just Got Panned on the tournament Ready Steady Pan. So, Gibbous is now 1-0, I believe, and You Just Got Panned 0-1. So, we are looking forward to the next round or the next matchup of this ridiculously awesome tournament. I hope I'll be bringing you that. I hope you've enjoyed this coverage, and I hope you've rethought the usefulness of the pan and your pan techniques. So hopefully we'll see more of the pan in competitive play, because I think it definitely has its role. Anyway, thanks so much for joining me, sending me your videos and all that jazz. Have a good day, guys.